because sooner or later, as we march toward our grid-style fiscal crisis, we know that kind of wasteful spending can't continue anymore.
One thing I don't understand here, Dan, is how they can hope to cut through red tape, bureaucratic red tape, with bureaucrats going into the city and adding more red tape on top. You don't cut red tape with red tape, and that's essentially what it seems like this plan is going to do. When are they going to get a group of people to go in and help this group of people that they had go in to help the city? That's, I guess, next up on the agenda. Dan, thank you, sir.
That's typical of government.
Yeah, adding layer on top of layer. Dan Mitchell, the Cato Institute, we do appreciate it. All right, more and more adults are mooching off of mom and dad. Not me. No mom and dad are watching. Dave Ramsey is worried, though. He's next. And a meeting with his idol leading to a meeting with the tax man. What a buzzkill. How the act of returning Derek Jeter's 3,000th hit ball to him might cost one fan big time.
The iPad is a great invention, but functionally it can't replace your phone.
a outrage for baseball fans in the country.
How common is it for, I know this is a common situation, 3,000 in baseball, but how common is it for the giver of the gift to also pay the taxes? So this
is it's very common. Oprah Winfrey gave away cars to all the members of her audience. A lot of them were surprised they had to write a check to the IRS for possibly $7,000 to $8,000, depending on your tax bracket.
Beautiful. I tell you what, thank you so much, Robert. Good to see you. Great information.
Thank you, Chris.
And Robert is a Yankee fan, full disclosure. All right, stop one.